We are back in Atlanta for the first national semifinal. Indiana and Oklahoma, the Hoosiers, shared the regular season title out of the Big Ten, and Oklahoma won the Big 12 tournament championship. Let's meet the starters, and we hand it off now to Jackie Bowe.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Georgia Dome for tonight's first round semifinal game between the Indiana University Hoosiers and the University of Oklahoma's Sooners. Let's meet the starting lineups. At forward for Indiana, listed at 6'10", a sophomore from Bloomington, Indiana, number one, Jared Jeffries. At forward for Oklahoma, listed at 6'8", a senior from Aurora, Illinois, ranked number 13, Aaron McGee. At forward for Indiana, listed at 6'8", a senior from Swayze, Indiana, number 43, Gerard Ogle. At guard for Oklahoma, listed at 6'5", a junior from Tulsa, Oklahoma, wearing number 2, Ibi Ara. At guard for Indiana, listed at 6'2", a junior from Noblesville, Indiana, wearing number 3, Tom Coverdale. At center for Oklahoma, listed at 6'10", a sophomore from St. Thomas, Virgin Islands, wearing number 21, Jabari Brown. At guard for Indiana, listed at 6'5", a senior from Anacoka, Louisiana, wearing number 32, Kyle Hornsby. At guard for Oklahoma, listed at 6'1", a junior from New Orleans, Louisiana, wearing number 4, Quintus White. At guard for Indiana, listed at 6'4", a senior from Clarkson, Michigan, wearing number 11, Dane Fife. And at guard for Oklahoma, listed at 6'1", a junior from New Orleans, Louisiana, wearing number 10, Hollis Price. Introducing the head coaches for Indiana's Mike Davis. And for Oklahoma, Kelvin Sampson.
There's wonderful respect between those two when Mike Davis was appointed the Indiana coach full-time after last season. He got a long letter from Kelvin Sampson telling him to go for his vision, be yourself. Davis has never forgotten that. And they meet now here at the Final Four. And Mr. Packer, let's run through your pregame points here.
Well, Jim, this is going to be an interesting game of contrast. Raining threes is the first thing you have to look for in watching this game, and I'm talking about Indiana. Comes in here shooting 50% from three in the tournament, but look at what Oklahoma does defensively against the three, holding teams to 29%. In-your-face defense, and this is something that's really going to be interesting. Indiana only has plus 41 assists over turnovers, and look at what Oklahoma does to their opponents. They force 154 turnovers. To me, one of the real key things, and I very seldom talk about this, is going to be the quick whistle. It is really important tonight that this game be closely officiated if you're Indiana, because Oklahoma really wants to come after you. Look at that early. And Coverdale's impact, not only statistically, which you see right here, but this is a young man that comes to a game with a chip on his shoulder, and that's necessary because Oklahoma may be one of the toughest teams he'll ever have to play against that way.
Oklahoma's first appearance at the Final Four since 1988, and for Indiana, 10 years ago, 92, their last Final Four visit. Jeffries and Brown to jump it up, and the Final Four is underway with Oklahoma. First possession.
Pipe on Price, one of the top defenders in the Big Ten against the man that makes it go for Oklahoma.
McGee and Jeffries with the block.
Got a nice piece of that shot. Good shot blocking by Jeffries. His hand right up there. McGee may be a little bit quicker, but Jeffries got a big height advantage.
Double team on Jeffries. Hornsby passes up the shot.
Looks like they're going to double down on Jeffries and leave Odell one-on-one by himself.
Odell and big pressure from McGee forced that shot. I like the
move by Indiana early, Jim, to go inside, try to get an inside game going so they can hit from the outside. Nice curl move.
Ball on the floor, and Odell has it. Tie-up, arrow, Indiana.
A rod down on the floor, one of the real keys for Oklahoma. When he is scoring, this team is almost impossible to handle. Got the ball very easily on that curl move. I'm surprised Oklahoma is not picking up a little bit more full court. They have a big advantage as far as quickness in the front, in the backboard area.
Coverdale comes off a screen, almost launched the three. Now Fife back out to Coverdale and making some cuts here at the start, Billy. Coverdale bounce pass, gets into the arms of Jeffries, and the foul on Jabari Brown. What do you see from Coverdale the first two trips?
Well, what I see is that he is going to be able to play, Jim. It may not be 100% efficiency. He's got a very unusual looking leg wrap right there. But Indiana, obviously, Tim Garl, one of the great trainers. As a matter of fact, the guy that's been the president of that association has obviously done a tremendous job. Now, Coverdale's funny in this respect, Jim. A guy who often gets banged up, but a guy that is a very good healer, and because he is tough, he was not going to be denied an opportunity to play today.
Well, it's like Mike Davis said last night, that ankle would have to be broken for him not to play. He did suffer an earlier sprain on that same left ankle earlier in the tournament and fought through it in their second round win against North Carolina Wilmington. White over Coverdale, and that ball tipped up and in by Brown.
Good job by Brown. Stayed right up in the air. Almost jumped up a little too early. Extending the defense now to the outside, taking away any three-point opportunities. Indiana's not a team that can break you down off the dribble.
An Indiana team that hit its first eight threes in the regional final against Kent State. An amazing 15 of 19 in that game from behind the arc.
Don't be surprised to see Jeffries outside some. Actually, the ball blocked that time by the backboard, but was too far underneath. It looks like they want to play Jeffries outside a little bit, taking Brown out there with him. Jeffries very good at putting the ball down for a big man. Odell overplaying even Brown to the outside.
Hurrah with a three and a swish.
There's a huge shot. That's exactly what I was talking about. The man that really makes the difference as to whether this team is a scoring in the 80s or down in the 60s. One of the things Indiana does do a good job, they don't put the ball on the floor very often with the dribble.
Odell, interior pass, Jeffries.
Another foul on Brown.
That's his second.
And this is the one area, and again I said, watch how this game is being called. This is the one area that Oklahoma can find themselves in trouble. Brown, getting into foul trouble early, makes Oklahoma become a small team in a hurry.
Two fouls on Brown in the first 2.5 minutes. And he's replaced by Darian Selvey. Selvey, one of the co-captains for the Sooners out of West Memphis, Arkansas.
Two excellent free throw shooting teams. Of course, Oklahoma the best at 76%, but Indiana right there at 70. Big overplays. Now with Selvey in the game, Odell's going to have a tougher time.
Coverdale fighting off a screen, helped force the steal.
Good, hit ahead
to Odell to tie it at 5.
Jim, what we're seeing so far is Indiana's defense has not allowed penetration by Oklahoma. Kind of surprising. And Hollis Bryce has not touched the ball in an offensive position. Fife doing a good job keeping it away from him.
Selvey in the lane. And it's Indiana ball.
I sense Oklahoma a little tight, a little different than the team we have seen not only knock off Kansas in the Big 12 for the tournament championship, and giving Kansas the first loss they suffered at all by anybody in the Big 12 this year, but also the way they played in the NCAA tournament. We're much more aggressive than we're seeing so far, particularly in the offensive end.
Coverdale almost got to the spot on time, and he forces the push-off call against Quanis White.
Talked about the quick whistle, and we are seeing it.
Indiana's road to the Final Four through three double seeds, if you will. A 12, a 13, and a 10, but the stunner over Duke, where they had a commanding rebound advantage over the Blue Devils and fought back from 17 down to knock off the number one team in the country.
Nice idea by Fipe. He realized he was going to be hit, so he put the shot up in the air.
Oklahoma downplayed any extra incentive being left out as a number one seed. They were the two in the West. You called that the toughest bracket.
By far.
And they marched through Arizona and Missouri in the regionals.
Selby did a good job cutting off. Odell had a chance to take it all the way to the hoop. Now see the difference now with Selby in the game. Jeffries can post him up inside. He's got about 4 or 5 inches on him. There he is. They're not hitting him with the ball soon enough.
Fipe in trouble, back out high. Jeffries can handle it on the drive. Tip back out by Odell, and here comes Price.
First chance for a little break, but Indiana gets back nicely.
And off the fingertips to Price. Billy, you talked about how closely they're going to call it. Four fouls on Oklahoma at the first break. None on Indiana.
Wow. That is so cool.
Can he do it again?
Sure. Go get one, boy.
Okay, so where does he get him?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Get down!
With a great taste that won't fill you up and never lets you down.
Ooh, that's a first.
Make it a Bud Light.
Ah, spring. Mowers mowing, blowers blowing, and the Home Depot has them all in full throttle. Come in now through March 31st and get no payments and no interest till January 2003 on any lawn and garden purchase of $299 or more with your Home Depot consumer credit card. You'll find great brands like Toro, Honda, and more. Buy now and we'll even extend the warranty on all Toro and Honda mowers for an additional year. So come in now through March 31st and get a jump start on the season at the Home Depot.
Cars you can depend on. The cars that last.
You never have to look too far.
Chevy, we'll be there.
Always with you.
Meet Baby Bob, a six-month-old who really has a way with words.
Yeah, here's three of them.
Watch my show.
The smash hit comedy Baby Bob, CBS Monday.
Contain here in Atlanta at the Final Four. Mike Davis gave an emotional speech right from the heart. He said to his team, enjoy the moment, take advantage of this opportunity. It only comes around once in a lifetime. Bonnie Bernstein.
Before the game, Kelvin Sampson revved up his Sooners with a highlight video edited to the music, One Shining Moment. He says, I want you to realize this is your time. Give your best performance on college basketball's greatest stage. Jim?
That's precisely, Bonnie, what Duke did last year. Watch that video, in fact, cut to their own highlights on the ride to the championship game at the Metrodome in Minneapolis.
Jim, Selby has got to be careful. He's bumping Jeffries every time he tries to go through without the ball. Great overplaying. You can see during this timeout, Kelvin Sampson told his guys to pick up the movement defensively.
8 seconds, Billy, on the shot clock. And Coverdale just realized it.
Good step out by Selby.
Got to get it away. Not in time. Not in time.
Good defensive stance that time by Oklahoma. First time in this game we've seen Kelvin Sampson play the way they're taught. I thought he might even pick up full court from now on just to get his guys' legs moving because they have come out very, very tight.
Indiana's starting five remains on the floor. Selvey, the lone non-starter for the Sooners, with Brown on the bench with two fouls. Price, first shot. Too strong, and McGee between two Hoosiers.
That's Coverdale.
And one.
Coverdale on the reach in. McGee just too strong for him. We'll see this right here. McGee, an excellent job. 9 double-doubles in the last 17 games. This man, all Big 12 first-teamer. Too strong, puts it up inside, and Coverdale will have to go with two hands if he's going to stop in there.
And he is a superb free-throw shooter, McGee, 82%. The first-team all Big 12 player.
Look at Selvey right now. I mentioned Jeffries has got about 4 inches on him, but it doesn't do him any advantage playing 20 feet away from the basket. They're going to have to get Jeffries down in the low post and make Selvey play him there.
The Cincinnati transfer, who has really developed into a dominant player this year, unable to finish the three-point play.
And this team, you can tell by that, Jim, they've been so good from the free throw line. That shot went up there extremely hard. Jeffries keeps coming outside. That gives Selvey an advantage.
Coverdale went back to Jeffries on the floor. Coverdale throws it out of bounds. Nope, they say it was touched last by Oklahoma.
Good swarming defense by Oklahoma, however.
Oklahoma brings in Jason Dietrich for his first action. Junior from Newport News, Virginia, and a sub for Indiana. Atlanta's very own Jeff Newton.
Jim, not a lot of fall off when Dietrich comes in. An explosive score and a very versatile defender as well. And here's Oklahoma going into a little zone, but Price doesn't realize it. He's playing man-to-man. Everybody else is zoning.
Newton outside shot. Jeffries very active. And this is going to be another foul here on Oklahoma. It's called on Selvey, their 15th foul.
I would like to point out something in regard to fouling, Jim. I think the way the game's being called is an advantage to Indiana right now. But Oklahoma wins 31 games, loses only 4. But this year, their opponent shot 105 more free throws than they did. That is an unbelievable statistic. Foul on the screen. First foul that time on Indiana. Going to be on Newton.
Newton in here, number 50, and another big body for the Hoosiers off the bench. A.J. Moye will no doubt be seeing shortly, another Atlanta product. Two Atlanta stars on this Indiana team.
Jeffries is being asked to do a lot. McGee on one end of the floor and score on the other.
Tough pass inside. Selvey works hard to get it back. Price, three-point shot, passed up.
Nice recovery by Newton. There's a three-second call. Boy, a terrific job by Newton defensively to recover on Hollis Price, who was ready to launch a three. He wants to get started offensively. Again, no full-court pickup by Oklahoma. That allows Coverdale to rest a little bit. You know he's not in the best of shape. I think Oklahoma should be picking him up full court, really make him work, bring the ball up the floor. Jeffries now posting up on Selvey, but nobody can get him the ball. Illegal screen again.
Jeffries, yep. Jeffries down low. Stepped in, tried to set that screen. His first. And A.J. Moye indeed is in the lineup now for Indiana.
We'll see the fact Jeffries comes over, does not set his body at all. Dietrich really took a shot right there. Foolish foul by Jeffries. He cannot afford any of those cheap fouls. He must be on this floor 34-plus minutes probably in this game. Set play.
Coverdale on White. White tips once. Coverdale comes out with the rebound.
Lost the handle. Really doesn't have blazing quickness even with a good ankle. Moye into the game. Probably the most athletic of all of the Indiana players.
Newton traveled.
Good, smart defense that time because you know Newton is not going to want to take that shot from the outside. Smart play by Selvey.
Indiana now, Billy, 7 minutes into this game, has made only one field goal. That was the breakaway off the steal to Odell. They've gone over 4 minutes now without a field goal. And Donald Perry has come in to replace Coverdale, number 12, freshman out of Louisiana.
You've got to give Coverdale a rest because of the fact that he hasn't been practicing. Bad shot by McGee, hits it anyway.
Fade away by McGee, and he has four for the Sooners.
But Jim, here's the problem. A guy with a bad ankle that has to sit down really has to be careful that it doesn't stiffen up on him when he goes to get back in there.
Donald Perry right here, handling it for the first time, so scrutinized all week.
Doubling from the backside, nice move by Oklahoma.
Moyer, Perry passes up the open shot, and it's off Newton.
Lots going to be asked of Perry. He came in on the year, was shooting 3 for 26 from three-point land, and the NCAA is 2 for 3, but when you come in off that bench and are expected to play big minutes, could be tough for the freshman.
Odell in for Newton as the Hoosiers have turned it over their last four trips.
So now we have two men from Louisiana playing point guard against each other.
Boy, McGee is doing a great job holding Jeffries off. There he is again.
Trying to draw a second on Jeffries. Another fadeaway, just like the last one. True again.
I really think that Odell will have to play McGee. Jeffries is asked to do so much as the number one position man defensively, is taking away some of his offense as well.
Tough pass.
Oh, White, I think, pulled a hamstring here. He's down. Let's see.
He's a little gimpy already. Yep. He sprained his ankle in practice on Thursday. Ball was kicked. It'll be Indiana ball when we come back. The last six to Oklahoma.
Hey, guys.
Never pay for long distance. Never pay for roaming with Singular Wireless. And right now, get 3,500 night and weekend bonus minutes plus a great deal on a Nokia phone. Nationwide self-expression is Singular.
At Midas, all we think about is auto care. In fact, recently, I had an idea for a kids show, a way to get kids excited about our business.
Wave hello to Mr. AC!
Hi, Mr. AC!
Mr. AC is very cold. The compressor pressurizes the... We're still tweaking it.
Midas, we do that.
In 1935, Foxwood Farms started with one horse and a truck. The horse was a thoroughbred, the truck a Chevy Suburban. Today, they have a few more horses. But there's still only one truck, Chevy Suburban. With an available 8.1-liter Vortec engine, it's capable of towing up to 6 tons, making it the best Suburban yet. Chevy Suburban, like a rock. This Tuesday on DVD and video.
There's ghosts around us all the time.
Ghosts?
13 ghosts. If you can't beat them, you just may join them. 13 ghosts. Buy it this Tuesday on DVD and video.
Why do I rent from Enterprise? For more cargo room. More people room. Or more headroom. Enterprise. So easy, it's like having a second car. Or third.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Ted Danson, Mary Steenburgen, Diane Ladd, Jack Palance, and Queen Latifah. Living with the Dead. CBS Sunday, April 28th.
Jim Nance with Billy Packer, Armand Cate, and Bonnie Bernstein at the Final Four. And Mike Davis had expressed yesterday, Billy, at the practice, his biggest concern. How will we score on Oklahoma? And so far, only one of five field goals and five turnovers by the Hoosiers in the first 8.5 minutes.
Well, Jim, one of the things that Indiana has got to do, they've got to get Jeffries down on the low blocks and figure out a way to get him the ball. The problem is, with Odell in the game, and here's Odell wide open. With Odell in the game, Oklahoma is not going to go out and respect him from three.
Odell with both of the Hoosier field goals. That breaks a 5.5-minute drought from the floor.
And that's really the first basket in the half-court set, and it was from an out-of-bounds play.
And McGee. Oh, that's going to be the second on Jeffries.
I don't like this matchup from Indiana's standpoint because McGee is just too active to ask Jeffries to play him. They're going to have to switch Odell over to him or get Newton back into the game. McGee is just too quick.
Well, Newton's still sitting at the scorer's table, and he was about to come in. Would he have been coming in for Jeffries and just a little too late? I'm sure he'll be replacing him now.
And now this really puts Indiana in a bad situation in regard to where do the points come from. Between the two of them, Odell and Newton, you have 4 3-point shots they've made between two of them all year long. So the game is going to have to be played from the outside, and Oklahoma knows that. Look at how Selby's picking up the defense. They are now really pressuring the ball. This is Oklahoma basketball.
And they're really swarming the freshman Perry.
This is a great move, I think, by Calvin Sampson. Pressure the ball because Jeffries is no longer in the game.
Moye gets through the traffic. His teammates will tell you he feels like he owns the city. Coming back to his hometown for the Final Four, showing them the sights. Dietrich, 3-point shot. Long rebound, Newton.
A little faster pace established here, and Indiana takes the challenge.
Odell was calling for it, wants to move in on McGee, and rolls off the rim. McGee underneath. Dietrich to the hole.
Jim, isn't it amazing how in the last two possessions we're seeing almost an entirely different Oklahoma team? And I give Calvin Sampson a lot of credit. Picked up his defense with some trapping, changed the whole complexion of the game.
First 3-point shot of the game, and five too strong. Price up ahead. Hurrah, pull up two.
He has a beautiful shooting touch, and right now Mike Davis might be thinking time because we're seeing an Oklahoma team ready to blow this thing open.
They turned up the heat, they turned up the pressure, and they open up the 17-9 lead.
Announcing Friends Fly Free from Southwest Airlines. Simply purchase a special discounted fare starting at $59 and a friend comes along for free.
You are now free to move about the country.
Tournament summary, only 1 5 seed has reached the final. No 5 has ever won. Indiana trying to become the first, and we have a battle of number 1 seeds in the second game here, and Coverdale, to settle things down, returns to the lineup out of the Indiana timeout.
Looks like he's moving that leg pretty well, but Jim, with almost half of the half yet to be played, Jeffries on that bench with 2 fouls, probably can't get him back in this first half.
Newton and
hold on.
Selby on the foul.
Sendry on the foul. Newton, who has had a tremendous postseason play.
Especially from the field, Billy. The guy has hardly missed. Second on Selby. And Newton with a chance for the 3-point play. Josef Zindre is in for Oklahoma, number 42.
Well, Newton got all this started in the Big Ten tournament when he was 5 for 7, 10 points, 7 rebounds against Michigan State, and has had a really good run in postseason play.
McGee in, Selby out. And Hornsby for Fife on the Indiana side. Yeah, that's 16 out of 19 from the field entering this one. 1 of 2, the start of this game for Newton. Hurrah!
Tough matchup for Hornsby. Hurrah, really a gifted shooter, and as I said, when he scores, everything seems to function so well for Oklahoma.
Newton drives past Zindre, and again he's got a chance to convert a 3-point play.
Newton much quicker than Zendre. Brown going to come back into the game, who got into foul trouble early, but Calvin Sampson sees that Newton too quick,
That foul called on McGee, his first.
You think Newton a little excited coming back to his hometown right here to be able to perform so well?
Looked a little jittery when he first came in, missed a shot, had a couple of turnovers, but he has settled down and hit for six straight here.
A huge lift for Indiana, particularly with Jeffrey sitting. You think of Newton primarily coming in and being the shot blocker.
Jabari Brown is back on the floor for Oklahoma with the two fouls. Juanis White has also returned. That shot right over Hornsby. Hurrah!
He's too quick for Hornsby. That is a very difficult matchup for Indiana. Hurrah senses it.
Inside to Odell. Newton with the assist.
Kelvin Sampson says you cannot help out in that situation. Jabari Brown breakdown defensively.
Indiana's half-court offense starting to work effectively.
Kind of surprising, working better with Jeffries on the bench.
And McGee on the blocks.
Well, there he uses that left hand so effectively, whether it be the fall-away jumper, and that time he had excellent position. Newton's got to make him come back to the other side.
McGee has 10 of the 23 for Oklahoma.
Little matchup zone right now by Oklahoma for the first time. Gives Hornsby his first look.
Hornsby with the first three of the game for the Hoosiers.
There was a change of defenses by Oklahoma that backfired on them. That's all Hornsby needs is a nice little look.
McGee. And that's the first miss after five straight
Moyer
by the Sooners.
Moyer going up for the rebound. Who will ever forget that block against Boozer of Duke?
And Odell cuts it to one.
This is a tremendous comeback with Jeffries on the bench, Jim.
An Indiana stretch that very much resembled the way they played against Duke the second half. They were down eight a moment ago, and now it's a one-point game, Oklahoma ahead.
It's time to spring into action at your Honda dealer, because right now you can ride off with a great street bike with financing as low as 2.9% with no down payment. Or spring for low payments, because Shadow 750 start at just $90 a month with your Honda card. Act fast and get a bonus. On select street bikes, get up to $300 in bonus bucks before March 31st. Spring into action now at your Honda dealer.
That was a charge timeout to Oklahoma. The next dead ball, there will be a full timeout, but Sampson, Kelvin Sampson, wanted to settle things down. Over Moyer.
On the elbow.
Was it a two or was it a three?
He was backing up, Jim. I really didn't see if his foot left inside the three. It is a two.
Two. That's on Moyer.
Jim, these two teams have met twice in their history in NCAA tournament play. I was at one of the games. It was in Evansville, Indiana. I'll never forget this. Billy Tubbs, that year, remember, had been hit in an auto crash, was not able to be there, and it was one of the toughest moments any coach will have to have. Mike Newell was appointed to be the head coach in that game, and to go out in Evansville, Indiana, with Wayman Tisdale, a freshman, to face a Bob Knight Indiana team, that was a tough assignment, Indiana winning the game.
Both teams over 50% from the floor. We'll be right back.
Are you sure this is okay? What if someone calls?
What if someone calls?
Sometimes you feel like being dependable. Sometimes you just want to go for a drive. Chevy Impala.
I'll be there.
Jerky.
Things that the thinkers. Things that the thinkers.
No. Cornelius Brothers and Sister Rose, 1972.
You want expert answers whenever you need them? Come to Office Depot, where our people listen, understand, and help.
How can I get organized?
A new generation of handhelds.
It'd be nice if everything was like that. Office Depot. What you need to know.
When you think of Italy, you think of things like cars that think they can fly. The latest fashions. You girls appreciate great taste. Want to go to Subway? Italy. That's where Subway came up with the idea for the new roasted garlic on Italian. Come on.
Our new roasted garlic on Italian is delicious. We start with classic Italian bread, sprinkle roasted garlic, and select spices on top and bake it all together. It's one of Subway's two new gourmet breads.
Maybe in your next lifetime, guys.
Subway! Eat fish!
I need a car. No, a convertible, a red one, with under 15,000 miles.
AutoTrader.com. With 2 million new or used cars, you can find the one you really want. And with millions of shoppers, you can sell the one you already have. It's the ultimate automotive classified site. AutoTrader.com. Your car is waiting.
Tiger Woods pursues a third green jacket and back-to-back wins at Augusta National. A tradition unlike any other, the Masters on CBS. Billy, let's check in on the Mountain Dew Eye Vision.
Well, basketball is a game of communication. Here we Selby and Arad. They have a miscommunication on the switch. Watch what happens when Newton breaks through. Selby makes a step thinking there is no switch. Newton gets the ball right under the basket. Good job by Newton coming back. And here is Oklahoma in a 1-2-2 zone. Newton again becoming an offensive factor inside.
Coverdale's first shot is blocked by Selby.
There'll be no doubling down on Newton inside in this zone defense. So he's going to have a shot, but it's against McGee. Nice move.
Beautiful move, and over the back on Newton.
He'd love to have that one back. A terrific inside move against the zone. And you can see in that zone, Oklahoma is playing the ball very tight outside, giving the easy pass inside.
That's the second on Newton, two on Newton, two on Jeffries. White goes out for Oklahoma, and Dietrich back in the lineup.
And the MVP of the region, Price, not having a big first half, Jim.
1 point. He'll be washing those hands at halftime. He's superstitious.
Well, he's being guarded by Moye right now, one guy that can stick right with him.
Hurrah!
Question that shot.
Yeah, way out there.
They get out of the zone, they go back to their man-to-man. So Calvin Sampson has used a straight zone, a matchup zone, and a man-to-man so far in this first half. That's Hornsby's shot.
For the lead. Back of the rim. Tipped up Odell. Moye inside. And it's Oklahoma ball. Near the conclusion of every tournament game, we select the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team, and to date, Chevrolet has contributed almost $8 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. Newton goes out with the two, and George Leach comes in, sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Leach, a good shot blocker, a lot of size in there, and this is a good move by Mike Davis because all he's trying to do is get a few minutes out of him and try to keep McGee honest. Let's see if Oklahoma goes to McGee early here.
Price drives past Moye, who blocks it from behind. Selby swatted away by Leach.
That's what he's in the game for. But a terrific job by Moye as well on that. He is an explosive leaper. This is some block.
McGee way outside. Off the shot clock, Indiana ball.
If you're Indiana, you probably want McGee to shoot those fadeaway jumpers because it keeps him off the offensive glass.
Leach looked like his old high school teammate swatting that one into the front row.
Chris Marcus.
Chris Marcus of Western Kentucky. Tournament team this year. Knocked out by Stanford round one. Moye gives them good minutes. And he gives them a tie at 24.
Jim, I look at Moye, not only good minutes, he's just as good as any starter that they have. He's strong enough athletically to play anybody. Leach on another big play. Probably a foul, not called. We talked about the quick whistle. It actually...
Silva really trying to mix things up. Wraps around, yes! And Leach gives him the lead at 26-24.
Can you believe this? Leach and Newton taking up for Jeffries, who's been on the bench for a long time in foul trouble.
Their first lead since 1-0. Dietrich traveled.
He had to respect Leach. I'll tell you, Leach is really fired up as his senior Odell.
They have come back from 8 down to take the lead, and you can get live team and player stats for Oklahoma and Indiana in the Game Center at cbs.sportsline.com. America Online, enter the keyword CBS Sportsline.
Jim, I really think with Oklahoma going zone, it's giving Indiana some confidence. Oklahoma's a team that wants to be in your face defensively, and when they give you three-quarters of the court to go ahead and bring the ball up easily, it's not the kind of defense that Indiana worries about at all. You can't turn the ball over if you're not going out and attacking.
Look at the points in the paint for Indiana, and many felt coming in they would be outmanned inside.
Well, the Duke game should have been
on. The way they out-rebounded the Devils. Coverdale tipped around, and it's Leach making another play. This could be the third on Brown.
It is. He gets there too late. Leach doing a good job going up with two hands. Jim, when Leach was recruited, people expected him to be totally outstanding. He had some problems with academic, not really difficulty, but a controversy between his transcript and the NCAA, but he was redshirted as a partial qualifier his first year.
So he goes out with three, and Zindre, who they tried to take advantage of in a matchup, returns. A junior from Budapest, Hungary. His parents have flown in from Hungary to watch him play in the States for the first time ever.
Good block out by McGee. Kept Moyer off the basket. I am really surprised that Price doesn't try to test Coverdale with some dribble penetration.
McGee will test Leach. And Leach on the foul. Tom Coverdale's play, Billy, fighting through screens. This forced an early Indiana basket.
Well, what was very apparent is that that ankle, although it may be sore and it may be heavily taped, he is not showing any ill effects of it the way he's playing out here.
Well, they had phone calls from doctors in Europe. Someone sent them some water that had been blessed by the Pope, supposedly. All kinds of remedies offered up by Hoosier fans around the world to make sure that Coverdale would be back to be able to play at the Final Four.
Hard to believe that a Mr. Basketball of Indiana, however, would ever want to sit this one out.
A 9-3 Indiana run. 26s on the board in Georgia.
Take all the time you want, folks.
We'll take this one in red.
Beautiful choice, sir.
No, black.
Black. That's actually my favorite color.
Red. Definitely red.
When software lets you quickly give customers what they want, that's one degree of separation. That's business with .NET from Microsoft.
The new Saab 9.5. With a more solid ride and a turbocharged engine you can't wait to take advantage of.
Yeah, you know,
can I try the red one again?
Oh.
Right now, lease a Saab 9.5 linear sedan starting at $399 a month for 36 months. For details, see your Saab dealer.
Thanks for the lab.
Out of the moving truck.
At that point, it was like my decision was made. I'm out of here.
Life is best told over a great tasting Miller Lite at a place called Miller Time.
Are we there yet?
After 7 years of trying, he's really here.
Good gifts of love.
I know.
Good gifts to hand me down.
Honey, who's that?
It's Mark, our financial advisor.
You've planned the next 18 years?
Yeah.
From college to retirement planning, our financial advisors help clients realize their dreams.
These gifts to
full service show, Dave.
Dave.
Dave is your friend.
The first name.
Dave.
In late night television.
Your name comes up all the time.
Jabari Brown has played only 3 minutes. Three fouls. Selby with two. Jeffries and Newton on the Indiana bench with two each. Some big minutes turned in here by George Leach for Indiana remaining on the floor.
Let's check this defense out right now. They go back to man-to-man.
Hornsby down and out and tipped out by Odell. Coming up single at the half, Greg and Clark will have first half analysis, plus the Chevy Player and Coach of the Year presentation, all coming up on Singular at the half.
Jim, against Kent State, Hornsby was 6-for-8 from three. Tonight he's had two good looks and has not hit them, rushing his shots a little bit.
And a foul before the shot.
Hornsby on the foul.
Thursday, an all-new Survivor in. Don't miss a competition filled with excitement, split-second timing, and controversy. The number one reality series on an all-new Survivor Thursday here on CBS. And Dietrich with a one-on-one. It's the eighth team foul. Oklahoma hits the free throw. Has missed its last six shots. No field goals made in the last 4.5 minutes. In fact, the two leading scorers... Well, the leading scorers for each side, Billy, have not hit from the field. Price and Jeffries.
Well, we're talking about two scorers that average between them 32.2 points a game have been a non-factor in this first half.
Hornsby goes out. Fife comes in. Third member of his family to be a part of a Final Four.
There's that matchup defense now by Oklahoma again.
Odell, tough pass, and taken away by Zindre.
Zindre did a good job that time overplaying, understand who was in his area.
Dietrich. Swatted away for a second time by Leach, and a foul call against Indiana. Odell.
Dietrich doing a good job blocking him out here. Here's Leach with his third block since he's come into the game. Doing a terrific job. Zindre's going to have to give him credit. And there you see the push. Dietrich going back to the line. Good, solid block inside.
Dietrich, 81%. 1-1.
Well, as I said, Jim, very unusual statistic for Oklahoma. Their opponents shoot 105 more fouls than they do. Which is very interesting for a team as aggressive as they are and have that low post game with McGee. But they are a brilliant free throw shooting team. In the last 4 years in the Big 12, Calvin Sampson's team finished either 1-2 from free throw shooting. That's just not recruiting, that's good coaching.
Another good coaching stat for him. They lead the Big 12 this year in field goal percentage, point percentage defense.
Big mistake by McGee, and he dodged one there.
That's a block call on Coverdale. That's his second.
We saw McGee go in the air. He goes in the air to worry about Odell, who is 3-for-8 for 3 on the year. And then he does a good job with that explosive speed. Coverdale can't get there in time.
Double bonus. McGee will shoot two. When they tore down the nets in San Jose, McGee took one of the nets, had it around his neck, and the team bus stopped by the local hospital where Kelvin Sampson's father, Ned, was recovering from a blood clot, and they all went to visit the old coach at Pembroke High back in North Carolina there at the San Jose Hospital. McGee took the net off of his neck and put it on Mr. Sampson's. Mr. Sampson, by the way, is here in Atlanta, arrived on Wednesday. He is resting right now in his hotel room, hoping to be well enough to make it to Monday night if the Sooners get there. Just didn't feel like he could be here today.
There's this matchup zone once again by Oklahoma. Coverdale tried to draw the foul. He wasn't even trying to make that shot. The official let it go.
Oklahoma on a run. Dietrich with a three. Zindrick pushes it out to Moye.
Leach has got an opening.
Leach lost control of it going up, and they're going to say Price got a piece of the hand.
That was probably a pretty good foul by Price. Leach did a good job getting out on this break, and he wanted to dunk rather than have to go to the line. Having quite a first half is Leach. Terrific job blocking, and there was that put away he made on the inside. Jim, you know, one of the things about Leach, although he hasn't had the playing time this year, Miami, a very good aggressive team, was a team that he played against, almost had a triple-double. 10 points, 10 rebounds, 7 blocks.
One more for Leach.
But he's only a 53% foul shooter, so you can see what a smart foul that was by Price.
Coverdale down with two fouls. Donald Perry back in. And that cuts that 8-0 run by the Sooners. Got one of two.
Price being very patient up there. Has not tried to push this game at all.
Sooners on a run, but they've made their last 9 points traveling. Their last 9 points have come from the line. They've gone almost 7 minutes without a field goal, yet they've opened up a 5-point lead.
You can see how Arah likes to explode as a scorer. So far this year, he's had 9 20-point games, got off to a pretty good start. He's kind of forcing things here as we go down the stretch of the first half. Perry ought to keep the ball. Had a mismatch on the matchup zone.
Five on the shot clock. Fife back out. Perry, the freshman, must do something. He gets open. Oh, he had an open layup. I think he felt he was going to get some more pressure.
Lack of experience, Jim.
McGee tips. Leach had a hand on it. Back out to Price again. And Perry gives the Hoosiers some big numbers here. The trailer has the wrong guy to go to. Up ahead. Hurrah. Pull-up jumper. Second time he's done that in this half.
That was a 4-on-1 break that Indiana didn't convert. The ball should have been passed early. Mike Davis thought there was a foul on a play. Hollis Price with two great defensive plays against the break.
Hurrah with 11. Sooners by 7.
It's March Madness. Elite Eight, the Final Four. And what will you see on the courts? Nothing. Those who lose get nothing. Those who win, nothing. Because everyone on the court is drinking Aquafina. The numbers do not lie. Zip, zero, nothing. Only Aquafina makes nothing this pure and refreshing. Now that's a sixth man. Aquafina, riding the pine, is the official water for the NCAA Championships.
This is a 1-on-4 break right here. Leach is the last guy. You want to fake here and go over to the right. This was a bad play by Perry. He goes to the wrong man, and Hollis Price with a tremendous steal. Really had the numbers against him, Jim. A small man, 1-on-4. He makes the play. Arah makes the jump shot. Arah with that perfect form on that jumper.
And it's a 4-point turnaround with that. Shot clock is off to close the half.
Let's check the defense right now. They're still in this semi-matchup. Coach Sampson has really switched the defenses around on Indiana, particularly now with a freshman point guard out there. He's having a hard time recognizing.
7 seconds. They call for play 4. Odell, 3-point shot. Bounce it down. Huge shot for the Hoosiers.
Well, McGee never thought he'd take it.
Nope. No basket. Had it gone. So Odell delivers a key 3 to close out the first 20 minutes. McGee, the big story for the Sooners, 14 points and 7 rebounds. Let's go over to Bonnie Bernstein.
All right, Calvin, you're up by 4, but your leading scorer, Hollis Price, only has a point. How important to get him involved in the second half?
Well, I thought he's taking good looks, though. I mean, as long as they're getting good looks, he'll come around. That last sequence there in the last minute, he had two great open looks from the 3. He'll hit those shots.
Coach, thank you. Jim?
All right, as we said, Hollis Price is superstitious, and what he does in a situation like this, he goes right to the locker room and washes those hands. Greg and Clark coming up, singular at the half from Atlanta.
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's National Semifinals. is sponsored by the all-new Saturn View. American Express. Autotrader.com. And by Miller Lite.
Days when I could live my life without you, without you, without you.
Your granddaughter, too far away. The dollhouse that took you 3 months to build. Who can you trust to get it there?
Hang on, help me find this way.
That's where Mailboxes Etc. comes in. We have 4,400 locations worldwide. We'll pack your item to the highest shipping standards to make sure it arrives on time without losing a shingle.
Hang on, help me find
Mailboxes Etc. There's help in here, real help.
At Michelin, our tires are rigorously tested. They're laser checked, x-rayed for structural integrity. And finally, no tire leaves the factory without a thorough hand inspection. Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
A lot of companies put out promotional calendars. Great idea for 7-Up. But instead of models, I've decided to use the 7-Up truck drivers. It's all you, baby. It's all you.
Love the camera.
Yes.
Very sweet.
Elegant.
You're trying to escape. You're trying to get out.
Not that good. That's genius. Sexy, kind of.
Greg Gumbel back in our anchor position inside the Georgia Dome. Coming up on Singular at the Half, Clark's first half analysis and presentation of the Chevrolet Player and Coach of the Year Awards after this.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. And let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars.
Get a powerful desktop PC. Without the desk, the Intel Pentium 4 Processor M, designed for notebooks.
Follow the NCAA tournament with live scores, stats, and analysis in the Game Center only at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online. Enter keyword CBS Sportsline.
Catch the smash hit, CSI, Thursday on CBS. It's all here.
Well, see, I didn't know if the arthritis had gotten worse or what. The pain had gotten so bad, I could hardly get up the stairs.
Mr. Burnett needed an ear arthroscopy, so he went to the place I recommend for all my outpatients.
The Indiana Surgery Center, and I have to tell you, they were great.
Streamlined scheduling, pre-op testing.
Well, no, I didn't even have time to get nervous.
The facility is designed and used by some of our state's finest surgeons and nurses with technology and service that lets them do things no one else does.
They got him in the very next day.
They just care more about my patients' comfort, their families, too. No wonder they're rated excellent by 95% of patients.
Even I was relaxed.
And she's never relaxed.
The Indiana Surgery Centers, part of Community Health Network. Everything healthcare should be.
How far do you really have to travel to bring back a smile? For dozens of Indiana trip ideas, visit us at enjoyindiana.com.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, the wireless company that supports self-expression nationwide.
Here at the Georgia Dome, 20 minutes are in the final. the evening. Our score at halftime, Oklahoma 34 and Indiana 30. Welcome to Singular at the half, everyone. Check out these numbers. Tom Coverdale for Indiana, 15 minutes on the score on the floor, 0 points. Hollis Price, 1 point on the night. Quanis White, no points, 1 assist. I'm joined by Clark Kellogg as usual. Strange things happening here in the first half.
Well, when you look at the backcourt scoring, neither team has gotten it from their backcourt like they expect to, but that means the guys inside have been doing a lot of the work, Greg. You take a look at some key stats. Oklahoma, an excellent free throw shooting team. The best three free throw shooting team remaining in the field, made 11 of 13. Turnovers, not a problem for either team. Not much happening behind the three-point line. But the work was done inside, especially for the Hoosiers. Jared Odo inside with the layup there, 2 of his 11. Then Jeffrey Newton came in and gave the Hoosiers a big lift after Jared Jeffries went to the bench with foul trouble. He scored 6. For Oklahoma, it was Aaron McGee, 14 points and 7 boards. And look at him do work on that weak side glass. And he made a tough shot here over the good defense of Jared Jeffries. Nice quick release and a feathery touch. And then watch him carve out space in the low post right against the shot blocking Newton. So basically most of the scoring damage done inside by both teams.
We remember Indiana raining those threes down on Kent State. There were 15 out of 19. Oklahoma's not letting them do that tonight. Indiana just 2 out of 7 so far from behind the three-point line. This reminder for official NCAA Final Four merchandise, just click on shop at cbs.sportsline.com. America Online users, enter the keyword CBS Sportsline. Well, it is springtime. That can mean only one thing. It's time for the presentation of the Chevy Player and Coach of the Year Awards. Past recipients of the Players Award include North Carolina's Michael Jordan and last year's winner Shane Battier of Duke. Coaches honored with the award include Duke's Mike Krzyzewski and Al Skinner of Boston College, who won it last year. And now, Leslie Visser with this year's winners.
Today we conclude the 2001-2002 edition of the Chevrolet Scholarship Program with the presentation of the Player and Coach of the Year Awards as selected by the CBS Sports staff. Here with me to present the awards is Chevrolet's General Manager, Kurt Ritter. Kurt, great to see you again.
Thanks, Leslie. College basketball is a sport rich in tradition. And for the past 32 years, we've been building a tradition of our own, the Chevrolet Scholarship Program. Through our contributions to the nation's colleges and universities, we played a small but important part in helping an entire generation of young men and women achieve their dreams. Our promise is simple, one game at a time, one donation at a time, but our impact has been significant, almost $8 million since the program began. We're proud to be a part of college basketball and to recognize the outstanding accomplishments of today's student athletes. And we're equally proud to reward students all over the country who we feel represent what Chevrolet is all about: hard work, integrity, commitment, and pride. Today, we're here to honor two people who also share those values and do it better than most. First, our Chevrolet Player of the Year. He's Jason Williams from Duke.
For the second consecutive year, the honor goes to a player from Duke. This year, it's two-time All-American junior guard Jason Williams. In each of the last two seasons, Jason has averaged more than 20 points a game, and his determination has kept Duke as one of the country's elite teams.
Congratulations, Jason. It's my honor to present you with the Chevrolet Most Valuable Player Trophy Award for this past season.
Thank you. It's a great honor to get the Chevrolet Player of the Year. First of all, I just want to thank God for allowing me the opportunity to be here. And second of all, I'd like to thank my mother and my father. They've been there with me through all the harsh times. And third, I just want to thank all my family at Duke, you know, my team, my coach, and family meaning everybody has helped me get to where I'm at right now. Thank you.
Jason, you've been so decorated, such a storied career. Can you talk a little bit about this year and Duke's early exit from the tournament?
Well, it's been a little difficult in realizing that, you know, we're here in Georgia Dome and, you know, seeing all the excitement and building around the atmosphere. You know, it's pretty difficult knowing that we could have been here. But I think overall, I've been seeing the bigger picture more lately, just in the fact that, you know, I have won. Even though we haven't won national championship this year, we won one last year. And, you know, I've won just in the sense that I've been with a great program and a great family, you know, my mother, my father especially.
And you'll be graduating in May. Congratulations to you, Jason. You'll be much missed in college basketball. And now the Chevrolet Coach of the Year presentation. This season's winner is Coach Kelvin Sampson of Oklahoma. For the sixth time in 8 years, Coach Sampson has guided the Sooners to a 20-plus win season. He's also led his team to a second straight Big 12 tournament championship and a trip to the Final Four here in Atlanta, where the Sooners are seeking their first ever national championship.
Congratulations, Coach. I'm proud to present you with the Chevrolet Coach of the Year Award trophy and a $2,500 donation to the General Scholarship Fund of the University of Oklahoma. And best of luck in the Final Four.
Kurt, thanks to Chevrolet and CBS for this great award, and I would like to accept it on behalf of my basketball team, our coaching staff, and the University of Oklahoma. It's a great award. Thank you.
And Kelvin, congratulations to you. I was wondering, much was made of Halle Berry and Denzel Washington winning their Academy Awards. Do you have a sense of history, being the first Native American to qualify for the Final Four?
Something that I've always been proud of, Leslie, is representing the people that I represent. But the thing that I've always done is I think I'm representing all minorities.
Congratulations to you. And most of all, thanks to you, Kurt, for your continued support of college athletics and academics through the Chevrolet Scholarship Program.
All right, Leslie, thank you. And while we have a moment, we'd like to extend our best wishes to Duke coach Mike Krzyzewski, who's recovering from hip replacement surgery. A heartfelt get well soon, Coach K, from all of us here at CBS Sports. Now, our Mountain Dew Eye Vision play for the first half may very well be one of the best plays you've seen in the entire tournament.
A terrific defensive play by Hollis Price, who struggled offensively. Watch him get back defensively and make a clean play on the ball as George Leach tries to get to the bucket, and then he takes it the other way and finds Epi Arak, the sweet shooting forward, knocked down the two-pointer for the Sooners.
Not a bad play by the little big man here. Now are the first five finalists of the Singular Wireless Most Expressive Fan promotion. Log on to singular.com to cast your vote for the most expressive fan, and stay tuned for the second semifinal game to see the rest of the finalists. We thank you for watching Singular at the Half. Will the Hoosiers or the Sooners vie for the national title on Monday night? In 20 minutes, we'll have the answer. Jim and Billy are back with the second half right after this.
CBS Sports presents Singular at the Half, sponsored by Singular, the wireless company that supports self-expression nationwide.
Can you say ha? Ha! Ha!
Ha! This is unbelievable.
Please hold for ha!
Never pay for long distance, never pay for roaming with Singular Wireless. And now for March Madness, get 3,500 night and weekend bonus minutes plus a great deal on a Nokia phone. Welcome to nationwide self-expression.
Got a problem. Nelson's in way over his head in that bridge project. Can you get up there and take over?
Yes, ma'am.
Stokowski, in for Nelson.
There is a start. There is a finish. And in the journey between, there are dreams. The NCAA Hall of Champions keeps these dreams alive for you. More than a museum, the NCAA Hall of Champions takes you on an interactive journey. Relive some of the most inspirational moments in collegiate sports history and walk in the steps of the student athlete. At the NCAA Hall of Champions, you'll find something for every fan. Discover what it means to be a champion. The journey begins inside.
Growing up, all we wanted to do was play. But as the world opened up to us, it became easier to get sidetracked. And just one single bet, one simple step can blow not only your education, but a chance to compete in the sport that we love.
They watch from the stands while their money changes hands.
The only thing worth betting on is ourselves.
What would be your reaction if you knew you could go to Sears right now, get a brand new Mitsubishi big screen TV, and pay absolutely nothing for 6 months? course, your reaction may vary. Sears, national retailer of Mitsubishi projection TVs.
Championship Monday, see why Everybody Loves Raymond was last week's number one comedy. Don't miss Raymond at a special time. Then, meet the star of the smash hit comedy, Baby Bob.
On my new CBS show, I play a talking baby, which you can imagine is a real stretch for me. On my last show, I was a renegade cop who played by his own set of rules. Hopefully you'll buy me as a talking baby.
A brand new Baby Bob after Raymond, Championship Monday.
Aaron McGee with 14, Ebi Arah with 11. Oklahoma leads by 4 at halftime.
Well, Jim, we talked about some of the keys in the game. Raining threes, and Oklahoma did a great job against Indiana. Just 2-for-7 from three-point range. They never really got squared up out there. In-your-face defense. We expected Oklahoma to be a little bit more aggressive, but there you can see Indiana, not much of an assist-turnover ratio. The quick whistle. I think the referees have refereed a very fair game, but you can see right here, Oklahoma getting an advantage. I think that's because they played a lot of zone defense in that first half. And Coverdale's impact. Well, Jim, he did start, but you can see right here, he's had little or no impact in terms of his ability to put offensive points on the board.
Oklahoma's 28-1 this year when leading at halftime. Second half of semifinal one next.
Introducing the agile all-wheel drive Saturn View, at home in almost any environment.
Wednesday, a new adventure begins when teams race from the heart of Africa to the bustle of Bangkok.
Get away from our taxi!
All-new Amazing Race, CBS Wednesday.
On TV's most watched show, the investigators of CSI will see through the eyes of a killer.
He's got a peephole into every room.
And into the mind of a witness.
He's a psychic.
Well, he has details.
But they never expected to see this.
I got an officer down.
CSI Thursday. Don't watch it alone.
Catch the smash hit comedy the New York Times calls genuinely funny. Baby Bob, CBS Monday.
Anything else for you folks?
Yeah, I'd like to have another steak just like that one, and I don't want to pay any more for it.
Well, then you should go to Golden Corral for the great steak buffet. All the juicy sirloin steak you can eat, seasoned and cooked to perfection, all on the dinner buffet every day for a great low price, only at Golden Corral.
Okay.
Now, during Spring Madness, get in a new Ford, because your Indiana Ford stores with great deals on America's number one choice. With Spring Madness, take up to $2,500 cash back or zero financing on F-150, or $1,500 cash or zero financing on Explorer and $2,000 on Ranger. The right deal now during Spring Madness, because we're with up to $2,500 cash or 0% from your Indiana Ford stores.
What you see down there on the floor is the best darn sales force in this business.
How'd that happen?
Training, Joey. Training. H.H. Gregg's big on training.
To do what?
To know our products. To know our customers. And to treat everybody with dignity and respect.
I am gonna like this job.
Get knowledgeable people. H.H. Gregg. We deliver like nobody's business.
Onward, retail soldiers!
CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's National Semifinals is sponsored by Mountain Dew, Midas, Microsoft, and by Mercedes-Benz.
What did you see with that Microsoft agile move of the first half?
Well, what we did see is a young man that came in the game, George Leach, played only 6 minutes, 2 points, two blocks, one rebound. Here he is, moving without the ball beautifully. Tom Coverdale gets him the ball. Leach stuffs it. I think that it surprised Oklahoma to see him come in so aggressively off that bench.
What do you expect we're going to see in the second half out of the two stars who were really shut down in the first half, Jeffries for Indiana and Price for Oklahoma?
Well, obviously, Jeffries is going to get back in this game, but he's going to have to become much more effective in the low box.
All right, Armand Katayan, what do you have?
Well, I'm talking to Mike Davis, lamenting the fact a lot of second half, second chance points for Oklahoma here, but he said Coverdale, Jeffries, and Fife have to step up. Only 3 points in the first half, and he said Jared Jeffries, he said we need 20 points out of him. And it's interesting, Jim, the last words out of Mike Davis's mouth to me was that's a really good basketball team. So he knows what he's up against, obviously. Back to you.
Thank you. Jeffries with only 9 minutes of action in the first half, 3 points all at the line, and then to the bench with two fouls.
And Jim, Indiana, the hottest shooting team coming in this tournament. There goes down to McGee again. A good job. I'm surprised that Jeffries is still playing him one-on-one.
Look at Coverdale, calls the timeout.
Smart move by Coverdale, but I don't think that Indiana can keep Jeffries on McGee.
Hoosiers timeout. We'll be right back.
Side may change, but the soul remains the same.
From oil changes to brakes to tune-ups, customers feel confident knowing Midas Total Car Care has their car running in top shape.
She's running great. Let's jump the bridge.
But where do you go?
Hugo, what are you going to do?
Total Car Care. Midas, we do that.
Software quickly connects supply and demand. That's one degree of separation. That's business with .NET from Microsoft.
Brady Weber!
Yo, he got next.
All right, Weber.
Discover a sensation as real as the streets. Mountain Dew Code Red.
You win NCAA prizes with this. You gotta drink Mountain Dew to do that.
You drink it?
Oh, I drink it all the time. See, we both drink it. You need to drink it too.
Robert De Niro is the mob boss with a problem.
I got stressed.
Billy Crystal is his shrink.
You don't hear the word no very often.
It's more like, no, please, no, no.
Analyze this CBS Sunday.
We've been enjoying these pictures from the Pontiac Vibe Skycam. Indiana ball here in the opening seconds of the second half.
Jim, one of the things that you have to look at, Brown has only taken 120 shots in the year. And on the other side of that equation, McGee has taken 428. You know that Jeffries playing Brown has got a much better chance to stay in this game. Here he is on the offensive end. He has to be really careful about a charge.
Jeffries hits his first field goal of the game.
And let's see that matchup again. It's Odell on Brown. And if you're Calvin Sampson, you want to see this ball going into McGee as much as possible.
Traveling. Jabari Brown says, wait a minute. First player ever from the Virgin Islands to play in a Final Four. From St. Thomas.
A rather circuitous route to get to Oklahoma for Mr. Brown, Jim. Florida International as a freshman.
Miami for the end of his high school run.
That's right.
Playing for Cyril Benjamin down at Charlotte Amalie. Here's Jeffries, 3 points.
Oh!
And home! And that puts Indiana up by one.
That is an omen. Indiana is 16-1 when Jeffries makes a three-point shot. Even one that banks in.
Well, what, did Davis want 20? He's already got five quick ones in the first minute.
But here's a problem.
And right over Jeffries. No foul, though.
And still, no move by Indiana to get him off McGee. And I guarantee Oklahoma's going to go down there and test him on that.
And here we see again the matchup zone by Oklahoma. They showed it in the first half, and they're going with it right now.
Coverdale, open three. Good look, and it's good for the two-point lead. So the guys that Davis said had to get on track, Coverdale and Jeffries, have done so.
Oh, nice rebound by Brown.
Took it right out of the arms of Fife.
Great timing.
Arah. And Jeffries clears for the Hoosiers.
Good open look. You give Arah many of those, and he's going to make them.
Jeffries on the drive, and McGee on the reach-in.
There's showing the versatility of Jeffries. Steps outside, can put the ball on the floor. Much as we'll see Drew Gooden in the second game. Two of the most versatile big men in college basketball.
Well, he draws the second on McGee, and just as you think there are advantages for Oklahoma in that matchup at the other end, I think Jeffries feels like he can really take McGee outside.
Oh, and that's
the
third. That's a third foul. What happened? Fife running right in to try to make the cut. McGee puts him on his back. This is a huge break for Indiana. And Fife, a former high school quarterback, gets clotheslined here. You'll see it right here. Pow! Right in the neck. Fife from a family that's got some Final Four experience. His brother Dugan played it with that Fab Five team. He didn't get into the Final Four, but he was on the squad. And his father coached at Michigan in 76 when they played against none other than Indiana in the Final Four.
So the third on McGee, who stays in there. And that ball kicked out belongs to Oklahoma. Thursday on CBS, the investigators of CSI will look through the eyes of a peeping Tom turned killer. You won't believe what they see. Don't miss TV's most watched show, an all-new CSI crime scene investigation. Thursday on CBS.
Yeah, we've got foul problems for two of the key players in this game, Jeffries and McGee. Dietrich loses the handle.
And Indiana comes out with it. Coverdale. Coverdale puts it up. And long rebound out to Dietrich.
Indiana has not done a good job when they have the numbers on the break tonight, Jim. That's about the third time they came down with a chance to make an easy play and made it difficult.
Again, McGee on
and
Jeffries.
No doubling down.
And a whistle.
Oh,
and
there
with
it
the
is.
Leg, that's going to be number three on Jeffries.
I really do not understand this matchup for Indiana. They can switch Odell over and allow Jeffries to guard a guy that's not going to touch this ball. Mike Davis has got to make the change. And it's not going to be made here on this inbounds pass. For Oklahoma, go right back to McGee again.
McGee, a jumper outside. Bangs it home for a two. They clarify, a tying two at 38.
And what also this does for Jeffries to be in this kind of foul trouble and see Oklahoma play in the zone, McGee doesn't have as big a challenge. But Jeffries' ability to use that pump fake and drive, he has to worry about a charge on the offensive end.
Odell, baseliner. All Oklahoma underneath for that one. Wallace Price still trying to get his game started.
Well, you know what, Jim? I really loved what Calvin Sampson said. Price is the leader on this team. He has not forced any bad shots.
Selby off the back of the rim. Oklahoma 1 out of 9 from three, Billy.
Bounce pass
inside, stripped away, and Arah comes out.
That's Price's second huge steal in this game. Beautiful pass.
And Hornsby forced it at the other end.
That was Dietrich's fault by not cutting through to take Hornsby out of the way.
Quick passing sets up open three. Fife for three.
Coverdale did the smart thing there. As soon as he caught the ball, he was ready to make the pass.
His first points of the game. McGee fade away. Boy, he has that shot down.
He really does. And, of course, Jeffries really handicapped here having to guard him.
20 points for McGee and all of the Sooner points in the second half. Half their total for the game. Jeffries outside.
If you're Calvin Sampson, that's where you'd like Jeffries to be taking some shots.
Price, that shot way off the mark.
Got a feel that it was hit on the arm a little bit.
Fife said no. I saw him shaking his head, but his last touch by Dietrich. Indiana's hit three out of three from behind the arc in this half to take the lead by one.
Premium malt beverage.
We weren't technically a garage band since we practiced in a barn. We still make a lot of noise, only now it's on the phone.
Introducing AT&T Unlimited.
Luckily, I pay one flat rate and we talk till we're hoarse.
$19.95 a month for unlimited long-distance calls to any AT&T residential long-distance customer. Call all you want, whenever you want, and never watch the clock.
I love them, but I'm not going to pay a lot to listen to them. Nobody ever did.
Call 1-800-REACH-OUT to enroll.
Hi, I'm Susan McGinnis, news anchor for CBS MarketWatch. I'm part of a worldwide team of journalists who keep you informed about the markets and your investments on TV, radio, and our website. It's where you should go first for the best information on the markets, analysis of your portfolio, and ideas. Our 24-hour coverage of breaking financial news combined with up-to-the-minute data help you make smart investment decisions. CBS MarketWatch is the number one source for financial news. It's more than just news. It's news you can use.
Oh, my love, I hunger for your touch.
Are you still
mine? Time goes by with the wisdom of Mickey the Nine. No need to test the drive. Time goes
by. I miss you so much.
One survivor thinks he's controlling the castaways.
That's straight out of The Godfather.
But is this Don doomed?
Don't count me out.
A new survivor you can't refuse. CBS Thursday.
Hoosiers dominating points in the paint. Oklahoma, the only of the four to win its conference tournament. Oklahoma winning the Big 12 championship. Duke last year was the only team at the Final Four to win a conference tournament, won the title. The year before that, Michigan State was the only conference tournament winner, won the title.
Well, that West region, Jim, had 10 of the 16 teams were conference tournament champions, so Oklahoma certainly was well-versed out there. And here they go back again. Let's check the defensive assignments right now. Newton into the game. They're playing that zone defense. Matching up is Oklahoma.
And Moye returns also, Billy.
I think that's a good move right there. Moye and Newton, the most athletic players that Indiana can put on the floor.
Newton short on the jumper. Loose ball. Newton battling. And it's McGee looking for help. He is able to squeeze it over.
Brown wants the lob.
And Brown lays it in for the lead.
Brown runs the floor very, very well for a man his size. 6'10". He can get out there and go. Now watch this defense right now that Oklahoma is using. It helps McGee. It's a 1-2-2, but it's a matchup zone. McGee will not have to go out on Newton that far away from the basket, so basically you've got two guys in the paint defensively.
Fife jumper off the mark. Arah on the run. Gets the roll.
He has such a great release on his shot.
Ebi Arah, the Big 12 newcomer of the year with 13.
Scored 52 points in the National Junior College Tournament. Should say enough as to whether a guy can score. That's a great place where we've seen talent for many years.
How
great
block that? By Dietrich. They say it's off Indiana. Dietrich knocked it out of Jeffrey's hands, and it was off Jeffrey's knee.
Terrific shot block technique to get the ball on the way up. Now watch Dietrich right here. Goes down, gets all ball, and then for the second time in this half, the ball goes off Jeffrey's foot.
Darian Selvey, McGee with a chance to get a breather. Steals some minutes too with the three fouls.
Hollis Price says Selvey's the best sixth man in college basketball. He hadn't had much of a game so far tonight.
White, that's a two-pointer.
Solid defense by Coverdale, right in White's face.
Hey, we've got some good Six men right here at the Final Four. Langford for Kansas. Nicholas for Maryland. These subs also for Indiana. Moye, Newton. Hoosiers had it up to a three-point lead. They've given up the last six. Moye, there he is. He ties it at 44.
And in this defense, unlike the man-to-man that Oklahoma plays, Indiana's getting a lot of good looks, Jim, from the perimeter game.
And they're shooting outstanding threes again, 6 of 11 in this one.
Just as I was surprised at that matchup that Indiana had with Jeffries playing against McGee.
Selby missing, and Jeffries chases it down.
Nice
nifty
move
to shake free from Arah. He has Pipe on a wing. He'll go inside to Newton. And it's a foul on Dietrich.
Boy, give Jeffrey some credit here. He makes the steal, and then that excellent dribbling move.
Monday on CBS, when Baby Bob speaks, America listens. Catch the smash hit comedy that everybody's talking about. All new Baby Bob. Monday, special. Everybody loves Raymond as well on CBS.
Jimmy, you don't see many 6'10" players that can put the ball on the floor with that unusual dribble as Jeffries did there. He's got Selby on him. Indiana can go inside over the top to Jeffries.
There he backs him in, and Dietrich was able to reach around and get a fingertip to knock it away.
Jimmy, you don't want to throw the ball. Oh, how about that?
Blocked out of there. Hoosiers with the numbers.
Jeffries is running.
Here comes the lob. Jeffries never had a full control of it. Price. And swatted away by Newton.
Coverdale has numbers if he can find them.
He finds it. It's Moye. He'll challenge Arah, and the foul on Oklahoma's Arah.
Some sequence right here, up and down the court. Newton doing a terrific job on one end. He has all ball, pulls it down from Dietrich.
That's the second foul on Arah, 44-44.
All right, let's see here. Three bedrooms, 2.5 baths.
A real fixer-upper for artistic creative types. Formal dining room, a sweeping staircase. Oh, honey, a fireplace.
Isn't that so fabulous?
We'll take it.
The new 6-speed Acura CL Type S.
So, you hanging up the whistle, eh, Coach?
Yeah. Kind of hard to believe.
So, can a girl buy you dinner?
Coach, sorry, could you help me with something?
Sure.
This goes up there.
At Applebee's, we do our best to be part of the neighborhood.
Looks like you're going out of town for a while.
Yeah. 2-week training seminar in Arizona.
Training camp. A chance to bond with your teammates.
To learn the newest tricks of the trade.
Get ready for another winning year.
Jeez, I really miss it.
Going away for a while, Residence Inn has everything you need to make life on the road feel more like home.
Here. This always works for me.
Now make 3 stays and earn 2 free nights. Call 1-888-MARRIOTT today. Residence Inn. Your Marriott awaits.
This Tuesday on DVD and video.
The ghosts around us all the time.
Ghosts?
13 ghosts. If you can't beat them, you just may join them. 13 Ghosts. Buy it this Tuesday on DVD and video.
15 years ago in a playoff right here at 11, Larry Mize hit one of golf's most unforgettable shots to win the green jacket. A tradition unlike any other. The Masters on CBS. Moye fouled by Arah.
Well, this is not the way to use your head, but we talk about a young man that has given a big lift, and you can see Calvin Sampson, he's talking to his team, start using your head a little bit more. Those were some bad decisions on the break by Oklahoma when they had a chance really to build on a lead.
Oklahoma's missed its last six, and 3 of those have been blocked.
Some major coaching decisions to be made in this game, and primarily, Jim, on the defensive end. How do you protect Jeffries? When do you put McGee back in the game? And Oklahoma, are you going to stay in more zone than man-to-man?
Newton down low, size advantage, and he makes it over Selvey.
Oklahoma playing an awful lot of zone against a team that really matches up against them in a zone defense better than they do man-to-man.
Blake Johnston is in the game for the first time for the Sooners, number 12. He can fire it from the outside. And here comes McGee, Billy. You were wondering how long he would sit. Seconds later, he returns.
As I said before, they can protect McGee in those zone defenses, but when they play the zone, Indiana, as we can see, has had a much better time getting open shot looks.
He was out for about 6 minutes. Jeffries almost landed on him, and he muscles his way to a tying 46.
Terrific job by McGee on the inside.
He has 22 for the Sooners.
That's his 13th 20-point game on the year.
Donald Perry back on the floor. Coverdale looked very tired before that last timeout.
Round on Newton, who has just eaten him alive.
Beautiful move, Jeffrey Newton.
And Brown can't worry about picking up another foul. He's got to be aggressive in there. Newton's having a terrific postseason, Jim.
And starring here at home, his hometown of Atlanta.
Nice move by Mike Davis to take Jeffries off McGee.
Brown tips it in. Jabari Brown.
And again, Newton is not blocked. Newton doing a good job blocking out McGee, but Jeffries did not on Brown. Perry had his hands full as a freshman in that first half. Oklahoma not taking advantage of his shaky ball handling here in the second.
Newton, he has McGee behind him this time. Kick out, freshman Perry, three. Yes! He's three out of four in the tournament from three after three out of 26.
And Jim, how about
on the season?
Newton? How about Newton?
To spot him?
He really did. He spot him on the opposite side. Perry had the presence of mind to stay over there and hold his ground. Much better when he doesn't have to handle the ball.
His shooting for Indiana from three is taking on Kent State proportions in the second half. They've hit all six in this half. Johnston drives easily for the basket.
Jeffries didn't want to take a chance at going to help out.
Six for six in the half from three after hitting their first eight in that regional final against the Golden Flashes.
Well, it was only 15 out of 19 in that game, Jim. So it was kind of interesting to hear Hollis Bryce say, we can't make 15 out of 19 in practice with nobody guarding us.
That's right, warm-ups. Well, they've got the change now. Jeffries on Brown and Newton on McGee.
Good adjustment. Even if Brown picks up a cheap one, you just don't want to have to guard McGee with Jeffries. Nice fake.
Well, Jeffries read it, though.
Another time, Jeffries with his dribble.
Over to Moye, and Indiana leads by three at the 8:40 mark.
Two brilliant plays by Jeffries on the steal and then the dribble to actually lead the break as a 6'10 man.
White. And a push-off called against Indiana before the shot.
There haven't been many college players that can do this at this size. Terrific dribbling, gets his composure, realizes he has Moye on the wing, makes an excellent pass in the perfect spot. Moye, as we talked about, extremely powerful, athletic enough to go up against Bryce and score.
Moye commits the foul at the other end.
He's hurt a little bit here, Jim.
Yeah, and not making it all the way to the bench quite yet.
It looks like he's holding his calf.
Second foul on Moye, but out for the moment, needing some attention from the trainers.
If you're Hollis Price, you have got to figure out how to start looking for some more shots.
McGee, that would have tied it. Tipped out to five. 3-point lead and the ball.
Jim Price, too much of an offensive threat to be this quiet for this long. Another foul on McGee.
That's his fourth. Monday on CBS, catch an all-new late show with David Letterman. That's Monday on the Emmy Award-winning Late Show with Dave.
Calvin Sampson beside himself. He has to put McGee down on the bench. The zone defense didn't even save him.
Zindre comes in for McGee. McGee with four.
And again, they stay in the matchup. Fife looking to get himself open, or Hornsby, away from the zone. They've had some good looks against this matchup.
Coverdale needs help. Reset it, 15 on the shot clock. Fife, Zindre out there. Hornsby stuck for a moment. Newton takes it.
Are you kidding me?
It's the two-point shot. Had a foot on the line. They don't expect Newton to contribute from that far.
I wouldn't think so. He was 1-for-2 from three on the year.
The Indiana bench, that includes Newton, has outscored the Sooner bench 27-8. The Cinderella Hoosiers have the 5-point lead with 7:20 remaining.
Dennis got a great deal for you. He's sitting down. A potato chip ad, $1 million.
Not interested.
Dennis, I just talked to the chip people, and because you're you, they say $2 million.
What did I just say, Sam?
No, I know, right, sorry. I got them up to 2.5 mil, and there's no eating of the chips. You look at them.
For the last time, I don't do ads, all right?
No, and you shouldn't.
And that's final.
That I know, you're right.
Done.
Exactly, I'll tell them, maybe.
Coming out of an Oklahoma timeout and a live shot from Assembly Hall back on campus at Bloomington. It is packed. It is raucous. And they are counting down the time here with 7:20 to go. Can the Hoosiers do it?
And it's the Mike Davis era in Assembly Hall. Man-to-man the entire game by Indiana. And here's the guy I think has to get moving for Oklahoma, Hollis Price.
Still has not hit from the field the whole game. Selby shot, swatted away by Newton. Selby steps.
And Jim, I don't want to downplay at all the fact that Price is being guarded by the co-Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year in Fife.
We'll be right back.
Hi, everyone. I'm back in town to get you on your feet again.
Get up.
Okay, fellas.
So what do you think? Good offense or good defense? Pick one for a chance to win a Volvo S60 at volvocars.com/questions.
Excuse me, my cab.
I'm sorry.
Can we share a cab?
Why not?
You're with Fidelity.
That's right.
Let me ask you something. I still have a 401k from a job that I had three jobs ago. Can I move that?
Most of the time, sure. It's called a rollover.
Really?
We can do all the paperwork, and you just sign and roll it into an IRA, and you can buy stocks or mutual funds, whatever you're comfortable with.
And I'd be in control of it?
Sure.
Get my life down to one sheet of paper.
That's right. Simplicity.
To invest, call, click, or visit Fidelity.
Brown makes me a hero. It lets my customers know I've shipped what I promised. It lets them track their own order from the time it shipped until the moment it arrives. Brown gives me the time to make sales calls instead of tracking packages, which makes me a hero to my boss. Brown works, I get the credit. How terribly, terribly unfair.
Better service, more sales. What can Brown do for you?
Bacardi Silver Premium Malt Beverage, 5% alcohol by volume. Your night just got more interesting.
Three pilots have entered the Top Gun training program. Two are flying high, but Lieutenant Kiki is struggling.
If something were to happen, he would be crushed.
An all-new American fighter pilot, CBS Friday.
Armin Katayan back here at the Final Four, where A.J. Moya has just left the court, headed towards the locker room. Jim, they've been working on his his right hamstring, the back of that leg, for the last few minutes. I'm told he may come back into this game. Back to you.
Thank you, Armin. And you would think they would need him down the stretch. Odell's back in the lineup for Indiana. And here he is inside. He got pinned underneath. Zindre, and a foul's called on Odell.
That was a rather easy basket, but set up again by Newton on a terrific pass. He is putting the ball on the floor, hitting from outside, blocking shots. I don't know if I've ever seen, Jim, a guy come off the bench and have this kind of production that was totally unexpected. I mean, he's had a good postseason, but he is playing an outstanding game tonight.
And Jeffries returns. He's had a good rest, three fouls. And Odell heads out with two fouls.
If you're Kelvin Sampson, two things you got to get done. You got to get Hollis Price in a position to start scoring, and you've got to wait for about one more minute and then bring McGee back into the game.
Can you imagine? Price is 0 for 6 from the field, and Oklahoma facing its biggest second half deficit of the tournament. Right on cue, he fires it. Down and out. And Coverdale with the quick hands comes out with it.
Indiana getting all the loose balls, Jim.
Indiana with its biggest lead of the game. Coverdale finds Newton for the 7-point lead.
Coverdale really limping right now. But he's going to, and here comes McGee and Brown in the game. It's time for Kelvin Sampson to say, I can't worry about fouls whatsoever.
A 9-2 run for the Hoosiers. Under 6 to play.
What Fife has been able to do is to keep Price right in front of him this entire game.
Price wanted it. Now he'll take it. 3-point shot at last.
Good job by Price getting himself loose in traffic. He's got to become much more aggressive.
And that team now only 2 of 13 from 3 for the game.
I'm expecting Oklahoma, Jim, to pick up their defensive pressure a little bit farther out.
Can't believe the 3-point performance at the other end.
Hornsby with one. Good screening.
And Indiana in the second half from 3 is the big story here.
That wasn't even that good a look for Hornsby and still made it.
Price fouled by Fife.
Boy, Fife is tired. Look at out there how hard he's been working against a real good offensive performer.
They've hit their 6 attempts in this half. This is the CBS Sportsline stat of the game. You can get complete tournament coverage at cbs.sportsline.com or America Online. Enter the keyword CBS Sportsline. It's actually for Indiana 7 straight when you take in Odell's shot at the closing seconds of the first half. 7 straight threes. McGee and Brown get back into the lineup. Fife for the second time.
Well, he
takes one on the chin.
Remember the last one, though, was a foul on the Oklahoma man, McGee. That one he had already fouled Price, who goes to the line as an 85% free throw shooter.
Every team has a heartbeat, says Kelvin Sampson, and Hovis is ours.
I think that Oklahoma's going to start picking up a little bit stronger. This is what I thought they'd do in the first half. Pick up full court. Make Coverdale really have to work.
Under 5 to play. 5-point lead for Indiana.
Defense is really extended. That ought to give Jeffries a chance if they pull him out to be able to get something down in low.
Newton full of confidence. Over McGee. Not this. Hold on.
Foul.
That's going to be it for McGee. They say he got him on the elbow.
He better be careful. He doesn't want to be too demonstrative here. But a great job by Newton, who is having the game of his life. He goes up on the elbow. You can see it was actually elbow to elbow created the foul, not the hands. McGee will have to sit. He had 4 fouls. Remember the foul trouble against Missouri, but was able to dodge that. He had 5 fouls and fouled out in the win in the Big 12 championship against Kansas. His team was able to pull it out 64-55. But believe me, Oklahoma would love to have him on the floor for the remaining 4 minutes and 40 seconds of this game.
He has been their offense today, and he's a senior, and he must hope that his teammates can rally here to extend his career.
I look for 2 things right now, Jim. Because McGee is on the floor, and you can see Price talking to Arah down there in white, the perimeter game is going to have to come alive for Oklahoma to get back in this.
Long rebound to Hornsby. Newton misses them both, and Indiana gets the bounce.
Coverdale never should have taken it down in the deep corner.
He got stuck and threw it out of bounds.
Yep, he got caught down there with no passing angle, had plenty of time on the clock because they had a new 35.
So Aaron McGee, all Big 12 performer who has starred in this tournament, gave him 22 points, 9 rebounds a game in the tournament, and hit that number today right on at 22. He's out. And Brown on the way up, Hornsby.
Good foul, though, by Hornsby. Brown had an easy dunk. And, Jim, one of the real subtle moves, and we talked about this as this game was moving on, when Indiana switched Jeffries over so that he didn't have that responsibility on McGee anymore, Jeffries stays on the floor with 3 fouls. McGee, over-aggressive defensively, even in the zone, goes out with 5.
Jabari Brown, only 50% free-throw shooter with 2.
And you can see why. Not a good release on that shot. Poor rotation. And now Oklahoma, if they're going to do it, is going to have to do it with full-court pressure defense. Moyer probably not able to come back. Doesn't look that way down the other end.
He's come back to the bench, though. They had taken him to the locker room for a moment.
Here comes the full-court pressure. Nobody helping out. White!
That was never seen by the officials. Fife did a great job. Coverdale throws it away.
White really upset with his former high school teammate Price. Nobody talking whatsoever on that screen, and White gets killed right here.
How is that not a call?
On what?
On White.
Well, you can have contact and you gain an advantage.
Inside. Rob bangs it home, and it's down to 2 at the 4-minute mark.
And again, picking up full court, making things very difficult for Indiana. If Oklahoma looks back on this game, they've got to feel that they should have done more of this early in the first half.
White on the push-off.
By dropping back, Jim, inside the top of the key with those matchup zones, they did not put that typical Oklahoma pressure on Indiana. It gave Indiana confidence to look for the threes.
It'll be a 1-1 for Tom Coverdale. The story all week leading into this. Even his teammate Dane Fife tried to help him out, gave him a book about Bear Bryant, how to play through pain, and he has played most of the way, but that's a big miss on the front end, and Indiana's only 6 out of 12 in this game from the line.
Kind of amazing, shooting better when they have somebody guarding them.
Yeah. Shooting better from 3 than free.
Right.
2 to tie, 3 for the lead. White got stuck. Selvey puts it up and in.
Almost like a rebound to himself. Smart play by Selvey.
Timeout, Indiana. 7-point lead has been recovered by Oklahoma. Timeout, Hoosiers. Katan and Bonnie Bernstein, Jim Nance, and Billy Packer back here at the Georgia Dome. The arrow belongs to Indiana, but the Hoosiers with 1 timeout. That's all, Billy.
Well, they have 1 timeout, but you can see Oklahoma picking up much farther out now. That means that there should be some space for Jeffries to get the ball. They have to figure out a way to get him the ball in the low post. He and Newton have been a good high-low post combination. Here he is.
Coverdale and Price very active on him. And they're going to call a foul on Coverdale for pushing off.
Selvey and Price so quick. Coverdale having some problems on that ankle now, Jim. Very obvious.
He's turned it over a couple of trips.
Yep.
Thrown it away, and here commits the foul.
Coverdale's going to have to sit down. It seems like that ankle tightening up on him, but good defensive pressure by Oklahoma.
And here's a great example of where they miss Moyer. Donald Perry comes back in. Mark Coverdale, father watching from Noblesville, Indiana.
Jim, that front end of the one-on-one that he missed before was a very critical free throw, particularly with his great free throw shooting team that Oklahoma has.
Selby on a one-and-one. Unable
both
to
teams.
Convert. Yep. Last 7 points to the Sooners to tie it at 60.
Oh, good lob.
Lob gets it to Newton, and he's able to hit it inside.
Now, that's what is going to be available if they're going to put that pressure on the perimeter. Indiana has done a fine job today recognizing what the defense is giving him and taking advantage of it. Price trying to play without the ball.
Honest White goes back out. Hurrah, lost it for a moment. 12 on the shot clock. Spinning on Hornsby. On the run. Hoosiers boxed out, and it's Perry underneath.
You're exactly right, Jim. Great box out situation.
Perry gets red. Sooners collided.
What happened? Newton actually created a screen on two Oklahoma players. Good recognition by Perry.
Under 2 minutes to play. The last four to Indiana. White stuck baseline. Price open three. Oh, that spins out.
Mr. Newton, it was his loss in this game. He is really playing well.
You don't defy the Newton law, especially in his hometown.
He has come back. There is that double screen.
Look at that.
Look at Jeffrey. He actually was getting fouled, but he sets a double screen, and Perry recognized it and went right in for the layup.
Newton back to the line now. He missed his last two attempts. So it'll be a one and one.
And a solid free throw shooter, though. 74%.
Solid on that one. 17 points. He has tied his career high. And you talk to the team this week, they would all tell you that he ended up with the ball in his hands at the end of that Duke game. And that symbolically meant a lot to Newton. And you can see his confidence soaring. He's got 12 in the second half. Hoosiers lead by six.
Can you find the sports car in the newest Mazda? The new 200 horsepower Mazda MPV. Body of a minivan, soul of a sports car.
Gonna knock over a bank with a magic marker?
They're America's favorite bank robbers. Bruce Willis, Billy Bob Thornton, and Cate Blanchett. Bandits. Directed by Barry Levinson. Rated PG-13. Rental by it Tuesday.
7-Up is proud to sponsor youth hockey. And for when they get thirsty, I've provided plenty of 7-Up. Because I care about the kids. 7-Up is now proud to sponsor youth swimming. Kick those legs, Tommy.
Cassie's first trip alone was from Boston to Los Angeles, and I was a mess. I was very nervous because it was her first trip, because it was one of the first times she'd been away from me for any length of time. She loves flying. I feel like I'm putting her in the hands of another family member. My name is Ann Wade. I'm a Mileage Plus customer with United Airlines.
Juicy Whopper, flame broiled, never fried. Crisp lettuce, crunchy dill pickles, onions, and red ripe tomatoes on a freshly baked bun. America's favorite burger just keeps getting better. Aren't you hungry for a Whopper now?
Follow the NCAA tournament with live scores, stats, and analysis in the Game Center only at cbs.sportsline.com or on America Online. Enter keyword CBS Sportsline.
A stunning Indiana performance to this point. The last six to the Hoosiers with 1:45 to play. The Oklahoma backcourt, Billy, not only Price but White off today as well. They're 1 of 14 combined from the field. 9 attempts for Price, 1 make, 0 for 5 for his former high school running mate, St. Augustine down in New Orleans.
Despite that, I think that Hollis Price has got to want the ball now in this situation. Here he is.
Driving on five, the floater, back of the rim.
Jeffries.
And Jeffries coming out with it. Indiana in no hurry. Hornsby looking for help. And a bump foul on Oklahoma. That's called on Selby.
Pretty good job by Hornsby just to go ahead and tuck in that time to draw the foul. Price did what we expected, Jim. He took the ball, but it just wouldn't fall for him. Having one of those nights you want to forget.
Dietrich back into the lineup for Kelvin Sampson. And White's out. 1-1. That's the ninth team foul. It'll be double bonus rest of the way for the Hoosiers. Hornsby.
Not shooting on the year. Great free throws, which is surprising because he is a pure shooter from three.
Kid who grew up in a small town in Louisiana of 1,000 people. Anacoka. Who watched the movie Hoosiers before every game his senior year in high school. 43 times he watched it. No doubt he was going to play for the Hoosiers one day. Selby with the putback. A minute and 11 left. And the Indiana margin is 5. Timeout Sooners.
Let me tell you how it will be. This one for you, nice.
It's estimated Americans overpaid $311 million in taxes. That was $610 for each taxpayer. That $610 could have been yours. Now H&R Block will double-check last year's tax return free. We can refile past returns. You could get more money back.
'67-'62. Indiana, Mike Davis in his first full year as the head coach at Indiana. Not awarded that title until the end of last season after his team was knocked out first round by Kent State. They come back this year, meet again in a regional final, beat him, and now he's a minute 10 seconds away from going to the championship game.
Ooh, great jump that time. Oh. Nice timing. And Jim, you know what was really unique about the naming of Mike as the head coach? The victory over Duke was exactly 1 year, the anniversary of the day he was named coach. So pretty good way to celebrate first year anniversary.
Two shots for Donald Perry. You talk about anniversary dates. One thing that might have been in the cards for Indiana. Here we are on March 30th. On this day in 1940, Indiana won its first national championship. In 1987, Indiana beat Syracuse on the Keith Smart shot for the national championship. And let me not overlook, in 1981, Isaiah led them on this very day as well to a championship over North Carolina. Three championships on this day alone in Indiana history.
Price down.
Wild scramble. Newton had it for a moment.
Arrow goes the other way, and there's not a foul here. Oklahoma gets a timeout. Really didn't have good possession of the ball.
Wow.
Kind of surprising there.
Didn't see that. 54 seconds left here. The Georgia Dome.
Look at these posers and wannabes. I mean those chicken fingers. Merely posing is spicy. You gotta try new KFC Blazing Crispy Strips.
All white breast meat chicken, freshly prepared, double marinated with a taste of chili and cayenne pepper for twice the spice. For limited time, KFC's got new spicy Blazing Strips. Get three strips, coleslaw, and a biscuit for only $2.99. Also available in the Colonel's Crispy Strips, the flavor that started it all.
Everybody in.
I think the party's out here. There's fast food, and then there's KFC.
Jim, that was a huge timeout call there for Oklahoma because the arrow is pointing in favor of Indiana. Ball, a scramble on the floor. Indiana never could get in a tie-up situation.
Indiana's bench has outscored its starters 37-32. And a 25-point advantage over the Sooner bench.
Out seven, you've got to go ahead and score.
Stolen away by Hornsby.
Again, Hollis Price not looking. There's a foul by Price, not looking to create his own score. I realize he's not having a good offensive game, but he's got to put it on the floor and go to that basket.
And now you start to wonder, as they are going wild at Assembly Hall back in Bloomington, what will Moye be able to deliver if Indiana finishes this thing off, what will Moye be like on Monday, and Coverdale coming off of this with the ankle?
Well, it's going to be hard to tell until we talk to the trainers in this regard, Jim, for Coverdale and Moye, because those kind of injuries, the kind of thing that can tighten up, and in one day you're just not ready to go. But on the other hand, Coverdale showed how he could come back from what was a very bad situation in that twisting of the ankle a week ago. But both of them are not going to see action the rest of this way. Short.
Perry,
and he goes.
Hits the roll. 9-point lead for Indiana.
Thinking three.
Hurrah, misfire, Newton. He has got to be our Chevy MVP.
And then some. An incredible performance for the young man that comes back to Atlanta. And we talked about great sixth men, Jim. He was beyond the sixth man tonight. Mike there with that scowl on his face. Boy, I'll never forget that reaction when Jason Williams hit the three.
And he turned around.
And he went to the bench.
To his knees.
Kelvin Sampson. Team had a remarkable season, considering the fact that he had to put together a group of junior college transfers to bring him to a Final Four in such a short period of time. It's quite an accomplishment, but they did not play that kind of aggressive defense we expected in this game tonight.
And Billy, you thought they were jittery early.
I really did. I thought they were very tight offensively, and I didn't think aggressively on defense. They really went after Indiana. And then Calvin went to that zone a great deal, and Indiana took advantage of it.
I think this is all emotion.
Yep, this is so much emotion. And you know, here's another thing. There's the smile. Bob Knight in his second year took Indiana to the Final Four just exactly the same. There's his boy who is everywhere.
His son, Antoine is 3 years old.
He owns the court.
He sat with me yesterday at practice, and we had a television monitor there, and I said, "What's your favorite TV show, Antoine?" And he said, "Mike Davis."
Well, I was mentioning it. Bob Knight brought his second team at Indiana to a Final Four, was beaten by UCLA. So he did not get to the final game. So Mike Davis, who had a better record in his first year than Knight did in his first year at Indiana, now tops him in this regard as well.
Well, I'll say this. Bob Knight had a large hand in a lot of these kids coming to Indiana, and they, according to Indiana officials, have not heard from him on this run to the Final Four. Not a congratulatory call or anything, and I find that very regrettable. Here's Brown inside for the lay-in.
Too little, too late.
And a steal back. Dietrich unable to give him one last breath. And Perry ends up with the ball in his hands. A team with a lot of heart is set for Monday night. The Hoosier hysteria will carry over to the championship game in Atlanta. Indiana has advanced to the championship game in its school history 5 times. And in those 5 championship appearances, they are 5-0. This will be their 6th appearance on Monday night. They will try to be the first number 5 seed to ever win the championship.
Dane Fife just said to his coach, "We've got one more for you." Put a big hug on him and heads to the sideline.
The Chevrolet players of the game, Jeff Newton, comes back to his home city of Atlanta and stars with 19 points, a career high, and 4 blocks. And Aaron McGee, who at one time had half the Sooner total, ends with 22 points, fouling out on this one, 22-8, right on his NCAA tournament averages. Yes, Davis and Goliath. Night and day at Indiana, or is it Knight to Davis? The Hoosiers are going to the Monday night championship game.